published 10:51 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 20th of April 2018, updated 10:51 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 20th of April 2018. The London Spitfire have some of the best Overwatch players in the world. They won Stage 1 of the Overwatch League and made it to the playoffs in Stage 2, but we are now halfway through Stage 3, and they've only won one match out of 5. Mail Esports caught up with London Spitfire support players Seung-tae, Bdosin, Choi and Jong-seok, NUS, Kim to find out why things are going wrong, and how they're planning to recover. London Spitfire have one of the best rosters in the league, so why are they losing in Stage 3? I think part of the problem was that some of us weren't in peak physical condition, said NUS. Perhaps due to playing games later into the night than others. I think these problems should be resolved pretty soon. The team has moved us into a new house, and in that new house we should be able to more systematic about what time we sleep, what time we get up in the morning and how we do reviews. We look at all the criticism that the fans give us very seriously. Thank you so much for cheering for us even though we've definitely been slipping in Stage 3. We're looking forward to getting back and practicing really hard. Bdosin believes there's been a bit of a mentality problem within the team. Perhaps they've become too complacent thanks to their success so far. Our team has one of the most individually talented rosters in the entire league, he said. Because of that, some of us have been trying to rely on their mechanics to play the game. What we are trying now is to focus more on team play, making sure that everyone is working towards the same goal rather than trying to outshine their respective opponents with mechanics. Through this process, we should be able to become stronger than any other team in the league. Spitfire support players Bdosin and NUS, center, spoke about why the team has been slipping. Understandably, the team has been down at times over the past few weeks. Luckily, there are a few players on the rosters who are good at keeping morale up. Bdosin helps bring the atmosphere of the team up because of his unique voice and the way he talks, said NUS of his support partner. When the atmosphere drops, he helps to bring it back up. NUS also says that when Bdosin makes clutch plays, it helps me look good and helps me make plays too. Bdosin is also supportive of his fellow healer. NUS is really good at ultimate checks, knowing how much percent the opposing heroes have on their ultimate charges. He also really helps set the overall direction of the team during team fights and engages. They also have high praise for Seung-hae, Jae-jonak Bang, the New York Excelsior player considered by many to be the best support in the league right now. Looking at the standings, New York is sitting in first place and he has carried a lot of games, said Bdosin. What Bdosin says is true, said NUS. At the sub-healer position you can have amazing mechanics but you also need the team to support you and help fulfill your potential. New York plays around him really well. The team recently moved into a new house, hopefully bringing more structure to their lives. Bdosin and NUS aren't the only support players on the London Spitfire. One sick closer, Young and Hyeon Woo, Hagopin, Joe are on the roster too, and have been subbed in for a number of games over the past couple of stages. Bdosin and NUS like playing, of course, but they also see the value in using substitutes, being able to watch games from the dugout and knowing what's going wrong and what we need to fix on the next map is definitely helpful, said NUS. Bdosin agrees, not only is it important to be good at the game mechanically, you also need to look at games with an analytical eye. It's good that we're able to watch games from the dugout and swap in and out. The Spitfire players call the support role the backbone of the team and gave us their favorite and least favorite things about playing it. As the main healer, you can't really make dramatic changes to the outcome of the game sometimes, said NUS. Unlike other positions that often make amazing clutch plays, it's harder to pull that off. Especially when we lose really close games, it's kind of frustrating. On the other hand, it's a lot less pressure. All I have to do is my job and believe in my team. For Bdosin, he enjoys the playmaking potential of sub-healers like Ann and Zenyatta. However, it's really easy for you to die if the opposing team decides to really get onto you and dive you. It's hard to position yourself in a safe way and also carry the game. You're supposed to be immobile and stay in the back line, but it's harder to hit people from there. London Spitfire will be looking to get back to winning ways after a lot of losses in recent weeks as for how to improve at the role. Bdosin says it's simple. Use the in-game comms, use your microphone. The two of them each have ideas for new support heroes that Blizzard should release in the future. NUS wants someone who's able to decrease the cooldowns of their teammates' abilities, while Bdosin wants an ultimate ability that allows you to teleport your entire team from one place to another, like Symmetra but more dynamic and on a bigger scale. They also have some ideas for what they're going to do when they visit London for the first time. I'm hoping, when we do go to London, We can have time together as a team to go and visit the landmarks and famous places in London, said NUS Bdosin has simpler tastes, saying, I want to eat fish and chips. It seems someone has been singing the praises of British cuisine to the Spitfire players. The London Spitfire are next in action against the Los Angeles Valiant on Saturday, April 21st at 9 p.m. British Summer Time.